T-Gray and MK, you are now cleared for flight school takeoff.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
All right. Good morning, everybody. I cannot believe you today. Oh my God. Look at Mr. Cathcart today, everybody.
Hey, guys. So T-Gray, before we get going here, what I want to do is I've been watching and reading a lot about working from home.
Right.
And so I've got a checklist, and it says, number one, wake up at the same time. So
right.
I did that today.
Right.
Number two, take a shower.
I'm taking notes. That.
Number three, brush teeth. I did that one.
Uh-huh.
Number four, comb hair. Did that. And then number five says, get dressed in work clothes. and then number six says, keep checklists. So I'm doing all of these things right. Right?
Oh my God. You know what? I'm taking these notes because I'm going to be doing a video soon on how to work from home. But I'm going to take a screenshot of you right now and say how not to work from home.
Oh.
By the way, those are not our work clothes. These are our work clothes.
Oh.
This is how we work.
So I should be like a little more casual then.
You know, this is our uniform. We vibe. You know, we're down with the Ibüümerang, the boom gear, and you look like you're about to give a presidential address on coronavirus with fake news and no facts and all of that kind of stuff.
Okay.
You look like you're about to tell us that we're going to all be out of quarantine by Easter.
Okay. We will be.
Some of you guys get that joke.
All right. Well, let's rock and roll. Are you ready?
I'm crying because. Yeah.
So for all of the new folks, this is
I don't even know what this is right now.
So flight school is something that we do every Saturday at 8 a.m. And typically, it's one of those things where T-Gray and I are together. But obviously, we need to practice social distancing. But I still like doing this, though. I still like doing this one right here.
You look especially ridiculous now with that. Oh my God.
Yeah, so T-Gray is like encroaching on my space. So, but I do want to apologize for T-Gray because he's going to get a little crazy today.
I'm going to get a little crazy.
Yeah.
Oh my God. No.
So I did see in the chats, we have people tuning in from all over the world. People are in from, I saw Germany, I saw UK, I saw Australia, I saw New Zealand. What's
I'm
wrong?
Sorry. I'm totally tickled.
What's wrong? Oh, somebody just said, MK looks like a new manager on his first day trying to impress his employees.
I've never even seen your hair like that. Like your hair keeping me out.
Doing the comb over.
You know what? And I'll handle the welcome for the new people because Professor Cathcart might scare them. All right. Hey, everybody. Want to welcome you to flight school.
All right. Am I better?
We do not even a little bit. Not even. You're going to need to do one of your wardrobe changes in a little bit. But please stay like that for a while. I love it. You're making my world right now. You are giving me life.
So, again, I should be a little more casual, right?
Not a little more casual. A lot more casual.
A lot more casual. Okay, I can do that. I can do that.
You do that.
I'm going to get a lot more casual here in just a few minutes.
Somebody says you look like you're ready to sign something.
I am. It tells you this in work from home stuff. There's a checklist.
Someone said you look like you're on your first date. Where are the flowers? Like you need to have like a thing of like
I'm ready to sign something right here.
Oh my God. Oh gee.
All right.
So anyway, new people, welcome to flight school. It might be morning, afternoon, evening, wherever you are. And we're so glad that you are here with us as part of the Ibüümerang family. And this is something that we do. Some families do Sunday dinner. This family does Saturday flight school. All right. And this is where we come to get all the information. So, for example, a lot of times people will be asking questions during the week that we covered on flight school. If you want to be in the know, Saturday flight school is where you need to be. We also do training. We do recognition. We often have special guests. Like today, our CEO, Holton Buggs, will be our special guest. And let me introduce you to the cast of flight school. First, you have me, the normal one, your vice president of operations. And then you have the troublemaker, today disguised as the professor, Mark Kithcart, your vice president of marketing. And we have to put him in timeout all the time. So if you see him misbehaving, just put timeout Mark in the chats.
No,
okay.
No, don't do that. Don't do that, people. So Wanaki says, Mark, I have the same checklist, so don't feel bad. Wanaki, thank you. We're reading the same checklist. And then Christian says, Mark, are you going to court? Maybe. I might be.
He might be.
Oh, there we go. Christine, no timeout to anybody. Thank you, Christine.
That's no fun, Christine.
Yeah, you can't do a timeout.
Dude, I mean, right. You misbehave so often that we have to put you on timeout. And if it's not, if it wasn't for me, flight school would never be like organized and disciplined, and we'd never get anything done because you're always acting up.
Yeah, no.
Like now.
All right.
Hi, like you really triggered my allergies today. I'm like,
we'll get to the DTRTs later.
All right, cool.
All right, we ready to roll, man? Let's dig in. I can't wait. Wait, you disabled my sharing. Hold on here. Reclaim host. All right. Okay. Let's dig into flight school this morning.
You gave me life on a Saturday, bro. I appreciate you so much, man. I'm in the closet trying to pick from all of my boom gear, and you actually put on a blazer and a tie.
Well, hold on a second. Hold on. It's all business up top, but in true fashion, I've got on my shorts.
You
got
to turn off your background. Turn off your background so we can see those shorts.
Oh, all right.
Because it got all, you know, weird and stuff.
None.
It's getting right now.
There. All right. So it's a party on the bottom. All business up top. Party on the bottom.
Thank you. Thank you so much for this. Oh my
God. All right. We got to get serious here.
Scott on. Come on, people.
Blue
blazer. A white shirt, a red tie, and camo shorts underneath. Life doesn't get any better than that. That's your VP of marketing, folks. Everybody, Mark Kithcart, give him a round of applause. Yes.
Thank you. All right. Okay, we've got people who want you to be serious, T. Gray. We gotta
get going. You know what? Fat chance of that today. You started us off on the wrong foot, bro. Sabrina Hunt, she's got it right. Said T-Gray is going to pass out. You are right. I am on sensory overload right now. I'm like a kid that ate a bag of sugar. Yeah, this is good.
All right. Let's move on. Hey, we've got, so you see these cool backgrounds? So we've got what we call the Boom Zoom. The Boom Zoom downloadable backgrounds that are on iBoom Hub right now. You can get them right now. So take a look at some of these. These are super duper cool.
Yeah, let's change up these backgrounds. Here we go. We got the boardroom.
Yeah.
Right? But I've been in too much black for the boardroom, I think, today. So I got to be wearing a white shirt. But boom, here we got boom, 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 freedom both.
Yeah.
like this one. Is this the sauna or this is like, what is this one? This one is, I think it's pretty cool. Mark, you know what? It's so funny. You got that suit and tie and you got this one. You look very, very official.
That one, then there's the, super cool.
Yeah, these are awesome. These are awesome. So are these downloadable right now for everybody?
Downloadable right now in the downloads page on Ibüüm Hub. That's under the resources navigation at the top. So you go to resources and then down to the bottom, go to downloads, and then you can download all of these backgrounds. And you know what? We're going to have a few more too. We're going to keep creating these and keep doing these. Oh, see, this one works perfectly for me.
You need music.
All right. So go get those. Go get those. Go get those. Cool background.
Over to, I know we got HB is going to be on here. He's probably going to want one of these. So let's make sure we get these over to him in our, I'm sending them in our group chat so that Mr. Haynes can have them too. And I just thank you, Mark, again.
All right. For this. All right. Good stuff. Boom gear. Okay. So I'm not wearing any boom gear today. This is definitely not.
Got that right. Unless we put some boomerangs on a tie, which I hope we never do.
Okay. Yeah. No. Never. We will never have boomerang ties. Never. All right. So. All right, so but you can get your boom gear. You can get your boom gear at boomgear.com. And if you have any questions about shipping right now, because you know some of the shipping may be a little bit delayed, you can send a request or an email to gear@iboomerang.com. Gear.
Bro, I gotta say this. That your suit and tie is burning my eyes.
Yeah, I'm gonna switch it up though. You said to go super casual, right?
Oh no, I did not say go super casual. I am not. I'm not responsible for what comes next. I'm not responsible for what you're seeing
you
right
said
now.
Really
I'm definitely
casual.
Not responsible for what comes next.
You said really casual. That's what I
said. More casual than you are right now. Like maybe just take off the tie.
Okay, I heard really casual.
You tend to be a little bit of an extremist, bro.
I'm gonna go extreme, bro, so.
I know you are. I feel sorry for the people. Oh my God.
So again, boomgear.com, get your boom gear. All right, and yeah, so just get your boom gear. Okay, for the folks in Europe, your clocks move 1 hour ahead, and we have adjusted the Boom TV schedule and the calendar that you can look at. We've adjusted that for you. We'll look at that later because we've got some surprises on the Boom TV schedule. That's coming up. So you could get it. You know what? You don't want to miss what's coming up on Boom TV when we announce it. So get your people on, make sure that people are getting on because then you do not want to miss some of the things that we're adding additional programming. And that's all I'm going to say. All right, so daylight savings over in Europe starts Sunday morning. So review the Boom TV calendars and schedules accordingly. Good there? All right. The Boom Foundation. So we've got some social sites for the Boom Foundation and they are posting regularly and they're doing all kinds of updates as well. Hold on a second, refresh Spanish Zoom, numbers are rising. Okay, all right, so that was Anna. Sorry, apologize, sometimes she sends us messages. So what you wanna do is go ahead and follow the Boom Foundation on Instagram and Facebook, and they're putting up all kinds of cool stuff. It's not just about the Boom Foundation. So it's about families, it's about supporting how you can support support the Boom Foundation, number one, but number two, it's about families and information about how families can work together and be together and do things together during this time. And also some updates as well about the COVID-19 virus and things like that and how to stay healthy. So the Boom Foundation is cranking out some very cool content. So go like them. on Instagram and Facebook. Good to go?
Yeah, we're good to go, man. We're rocking. I am just marveling at your extreme professionalism today. It's making me itch.
All right, so the Boom Foundation, though, where do they get all of the donations that they receive? There are a couple of different ways they receive donations. One is you can donate directly in your back office up at the top. You log in, and up at the top, there's that little icon that you see here on the screen, this little icon down here. That icon is up at the top, and you can click that icon and donate. The other way you can do it is by giving out boomerangs and those boomerangs getting activated. So activating those boomerangs is another way that you can support the Boom Foundation. So, and we've got people that are activating boomerangs big time, big time, big time, big time. And so let's get into the Boom Clubs.
Yes, let's do that. Let's do it. All right, I'm going to go first. I think I'm going to go first. I might be setting myself up for disaster, but who knows? We'll just go ahead and just jump right in. All right, we'll see if we can do this without destroying anyone's name in the process. We're going to start with congratulating Danielle, Chris, Dawn, and Jessica for joining the Boom 100 Club. Way to go, you guys. Boom. Awesome.
Awesome, and we got the Boom 200 Club. We've got Scott, Phil, and Patty, and Tamika. Good job, guys.
All right. In the Boom 300 Club, Lori. Way to go, Lori.
Boom 400, Evander.
I wasn't even trying that last name. Lori G. Oh, wait, come on. Who was that? Boom 400. I'm sorry. I was talking when you were talking.
Oh, no. It was Evander. I already did it.
Oh, Evander what?
I did Evander.
Evander Jonakin III.
Yeah. Ooh.
Yeah.
Your turn.
Cole Wilson, Dana Whiteley, Tia Gross, congratulations on being in the Boom 500 Club. 500.
All right. Boom 600, Bart, man, you rock. You are awesome. Good stuff, Bart.
Double B. Boom 700 Club, Rich and Sophier Douglin. Way to go. 700 customers. Yes.
Now we get up into the big numbers. The Boom 1500 Club, Teresa and Samuel Williams. You guys are awesome. And that means 1,500 activated boomerangs.
Wow.
That provides servings of proper nutrition to children for the Boom Foundation. So good job, you guys. Excellent.
Their customer report has a lot of pages. That's what I'm talking about,
Sam. It does. Yes. Dun, dun, dun.
1,800. Shirley Xavier won't stop, can't stop, won't stop. Shirley, way to do it. 2,000 is within reach. You're gonna have it before you know it. Yes. Way to go, Shirley.
Shirley texted me this morning and said she has 1,804 to be precise, to be exact.
Girl, that's what I'm talking about. Shirley Xavier. In the house. You missed it. Mark, you missed it. You were looking down. You ready? Ready?
Yeah.
From now on, when we talk about Shirley, we gotta go like this. Shirley Xavier in the house. That's what I'm talking about.
All right, Shirley. And that was Shirley speaking.
Can you do it again?
What's that?
The X again. Bro, you didn't put your cufflinks in?
No.
So you got this dressed up, you tie the jacket, but you didn't like the sleeves?
I got to do a quick change here, man. I can't be dealing with cufflinks.
That's no change.
All right, Shirley.
All right.
Awesome. So, and this is Shirley. She got the
Rose Hart said busted. Yeah, that's right, Rose. I busted him.
So Shirley got to speak at Accelerate. This is the photo of her at Accelerate speaking on stage in front of thousands and thousands of people. So that was so cool. And Renee Young got to speak as well. So keep getting those boomerangs out there, get them activated, and keep on rocking, ladies.
Awesome. Hey, and I've got a message for Tunde Brinson, our VP of Boom Gear. I want to let Tunde know that this week, okay, hold on, I got to stop my background for a second so I can come clean here. Okay, I've got my Boom Gear mug and proper tools here instead of the blue and white coffee cup that I had last week. So I just want you to know I'm coming correct.
Okay.
I got put on timeout for that last week, folks. I just had
Okay. All right. Okay. Yeah. All right. We've got hashtag good stories for you and good videos today. So what is hashtag good, Mr. T. Greg?
Hashtag good is what we say to, it's a philosophy that we have at Ibüümerang, and it's a very important philosophy. It's part of our culture, you know, where if you live in Dallas and you're a Dallas Cowboy fan, it stands for get out of Dallas. That's what it stands for. Get out of Dallas. I'm going to go with that. Get out of Dallas. I'll take it out of Dallas for 500, Chuck. That's what I'm going to go with.
Tim got it. Tim got get out of debt.
That works too. It's cute.
All right. Get out of distraction. Hey, I like that, Christine.
Get out of distraction. Get out of distraction, right?
All right. Well, hey, it means get out of debt is what it means. So, and what we're talking about is, and this is one of our core philosophies. This is one of our core philosophies at Ibüümerang. One is throw out goodwill. Don't expect anything in return, and goodwill will come back. Second, we've got hashtag good, and that is get out of debt. We don't want you guys getting into debt. It's better to get out of debt and be able to be free of debt than it is to accumulate debt. And we want to encourage that. We want to encourage you to make sure that you are putting income from Ibüümerang and putting it towards debt. And
you know what, professor, let, you know, Professor Kidcourt, you know, get out of debt is an incredible philosophy. It's one of the things that makes Ibüümerang hashtag just different, because throughout network marketing, unfortunately, it has been an industry-wide culture of encouraging people to take the money that they make from their network marketing business and go out and get into debt with houses and cars and things that they can't afford so that they can try to impress people and make them think that they're more successful than they really are. And at Ibüümerang, we believe that the truth is good enough. If you're just getting started, you're just getting started, right? If you're not making a fortune yet, but you're just making some, great, that's a good enough story. And so what we would rather do is, as you start to earn money in Ibüümerang, use that money to get out of debt. And so, you know, we have our Boom TV schedule, which is absolutely amazing, right, Professor? And I'm going to call you that until you are not Professor anymore. And so on Thursday of this week, and I hope you guys are tuning into Conversations with Entrepreneurs, because we have people come on and tell their stories. But one of the people we interviewed was Luis Enrique Cruz from Puerto Rico. And when he got started in network marketing, he was working three jobs. He was doing valet parking for two different companies. He was delivering pizza, right? That's what he was doing. And a year ago, when he joined Ibüümerang, when he got started in Ibüümerang, he had been working some other jobs. But in the first 3 months of working in Ibüümerang, and he worked really hard, he was able to make enough to pay off all his debts. And that's what this is about, to get debt free. And if you think about being in a time like this with the coronavirus and people are worried about their income, what a great position to be in to have used your early Ibüümerang money to pay off your debts. That's what this is about.
Awesome. Let's run a video.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, Ibüümerang family. It is Terrell and
DeAndrea Fierce.
And we're the Fierce family, and we're here to give you all some good news in the midst of what's all that's going on. We were able to pay off two of my wife's student loans and one of our credit cards by Ibüümerang Commissions. Yes. It is so good to be a part of a company that lives by the philosophy of G-O-O-D, get out of debt. And guess what? We believe the same thing, that you should owe no man nothing but to love them. And we are using Ibüümerang to dig our way out of debt, and you should too. So I just want to send that word of encouragement. Keep on building, keep on dreaming. And like they say, get out of debt.
Boom. Boom.
Awesome.
I love that. What a great video.
Yeah. So, two student loans, one credit card, and they hit the Boom 300 Club last week.
It doesn't get any better than that. And you know what else, too, I like about it? They've got such a great name, the Fierce Family. I mean, come on. That's so awesome.
Yeah. So we've got another one. We've got another one. All right. Let's see here. Let's make this happen. There we go. There we go. And there we go.
Hey, Boom family, Leslie Green here in Washington, D.C. Just wanted to share my good story with you. This past weekend while we were in Houston at Accelerate, I made the final payment on my sole credit card bill that I've had over the last 5 years or so since journeying into full-time entrepreneurship. And I want you to know, I didn't just pay it off, I paid it off early, y'all. And it's due to the commissions that I've been able to earn over the past year from Ibüümerang. And I promise you, it literally could not have been done without those commissions. And what I'm most looking forward to is over the next couple of years or so, being able to pay off my final piece of debt, which is my mortgage. I truly believe in my heart of hearts that it is possible. And I want you to believe that as well. So I want you to keep booming, and I'll see you at the next convention. Boom!
Awesome. Leslie,
what an awesome story. I love these videos. Way to go, Leslie Green. Pay it off. Pay it off. People, hashtag good. Get out of debt. Yes.
Awesome. So very, very cool stories. And thankfully, you know, people are doing this even during this time that we're in. And it's cool. It's cool to watch this happening.
It sure is. I'm going to put up the disclaimer for 2 seconds here. And I think it's important because, you know, we're talking about money. And, you know, folks, first of all, I just want to say this. People in Ibüümerang are really making money, right? But it's very important that we don't ever give people the impression that we're guaranteeing them an income, you know, or making income claims. You know, the way it works in Ibüümerang, the comp plan is the comp plan. It's the same for everybody. And it's really, you know, 1 + 1 equals whatever, it's 1 + 1 equals 2 every time for each person. So you do the work, you make what the comp plan says you're gonna make. But here's the thing, everybody's gonna do different work. Some people are gonna stick with it. Some people are gonna quit. Some people are gonna do a little work. Some people are gonna do a lot of work. And guess what? When you do that, that determines how much money you make. But obviously these folks, they did the work so that they could make the money and they could pay off their debts, which I think is fantastic. All right, I'm just gonna tell you guys, I already know what's about to happen. I cannot be responsible for what comes next. We need to have a Kith Cart disclaimer to cover that, is to cover circumstances and moments such as this. Okay, here we go.
You said get really, 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 casual, right?
You came back looking like cotton candy explosion. I cannot stand it. Oh my God, I can't take it.
Is this better?
Oh, no. Marginally, from the neck down, it's better.
All right.
No, you should have kept it on for a while. We liked it, actually.
All right.
There it goes. There's my tunicorn. That's what I'm talking about.
All right, brother.
I love it. I wish you could put that wig back on though. It was hysterical. And we have to, please, yes, yes. Oh, I love it. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
All right, let's move on. DTRTs. T-Gray, what do you got?
I got, it's itching. I don't know what to do. But right now, you know what? It's kind of like, I feel like a kid in the hospital. I'm suffering from some sort of illness. And then Ibüümerang the clown comes and cheers me up.
Ibüümerang the clown. All right. Well, cool. Well, hey, you know, hey, somebody just said, I'm disco.
Yeah, you are definitely disco. This is a good moment for the sprinkler.
I'm gonna have to find it. Oh, the sprinkler.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, guys. So let's get into the DTRTs.
DTRT.
You itchy?
I'm itchy. I mean, right. You actually have a case of the DTRTs too. I'm wondering if it's a mental illness.
It might be. All right. So, well, hey, yeah, how many days has it been since we've been on lockdown?
You are definitely having some cabin fever over there.
Man, I'm telling you, I was going through boxes and looking for stuff and found this. Yeah. I found some other things too.
I'm very concerned.
All right. So DTRTs, that is doing the right things. Hashtag doing the right things. And we want to catch you doing the right thing. So the folks with the good stories, they're doing the right things. They are doing exactly the right things. The people in the boom clubs, they're doing the right things. Okay. So we want to catch you doing the right things. So some of these are going to be, you know, that they're not practicing social distancing. These were done. These pictures came in from a while back. Now, one person is though. So we got Stephanie Bryant, Alicia Harrell, Daryl, and TJ Bush, and Kiara Lasky in Memphis, Tennessee. So we want to make sure that, you know, they're together there. But that was before the social distancing. Then we've got Donna and Kiara. Now they are practicing a good social distance. And it looks like Kiara, she's even using a little background there in the back, I can see. Looks like she's at the beach. And then Jackie Underwood and her team, they are also practicing social distancing as well. So congratulations, ladies and gentlemen, on practicing social distancing, but continuing to build your business. All right. Now, we've also got Bill and Jennifer Corser, Peggy Simpson, Susan Maurice, and Bartlett meeting via Zoom. They meet via Zoom. So very cool. And Bart, I know he just, what was it? He hit the Boom 700 Club. So, man, they're not slowing down. As a matter of fact, I think they're picking up speed. Now, the New Zealand team.
Yeah, they seem to be having some difficulty with the social distancing concept, or this is an old picture.
Yeah. No, this is from this past week. But you guys are not.
They've got more than 10 people. They are not 5 or 6 feet apart.
Yep, they're all up in each other's space.
Yeah.
but hey, you know what? They're rocking and rolling and appreciate it. Now, one thing I did hear is New Zealand did a big time lockdown. And they've done it before everybody else. So bottom line is I think over there in New Zealand, I don't think you're gonna be seeing any more pictures like this. All right, good stuff. And then we've got Kimberly, Leslie, Valita, Jackie, Kimberly, Jason, Grace, Terry, Rachel, Stephanie, Janelle, Susan, Gary, and Terry meeting via Zoom. So awesome.
And you know what I love about this? So first of all, I want to congratulate these guys because if you're going to, you know, based on our rules, if you're going to send us a picture of a computer screen, this is the way to do it, right? So they blacked out all the names. But then all the names are right there to the left anyway.
Yeah, but here's the thing. I checked and Leslie even said when she sent it in, she said everybody approved to have their name on flight school their picture.
That's right.
Just make sure you're getting that okay from everybody. Otherwise we can't show them. And if you do send one in like this, let us know that everybody in that photo, and we're still gonna block the names though, just so you can't match them up, and we're not using last names. So, bottom line is send those pictures in and make sure that you block the names out, but then give us the names, but block the names out.
All right. We appreciate pictures like this because sometimes in our presentations, like the basic training, we were looking for some good Zoom slides. And if we had this one, this would have definitely been a good one for us to use. So we love that. Keep them coming, folks. Keep rocking. Zoom, Zoom, Zoom. Boom, Zoom, boom, Zoom, boom, Zoom.
Yeah. And you got the backgrounds for it now.
That's right.
All right. For boom, Zooming. All right, customer corner. You want to take these, Greg?
Boom. Saving money.
You want to take these?
Sure, Dana. Dana Whitley, she saved, or she saved $28.22 and earned 107 reward credits. And this is super exciting because guess what? Our customers earn reward credits now. We absolutely love it. All right, Mark, you're still advancing the slides though, Mark. He gave it to me. All right.
Shelterling saved $31.28 on her hotel booking for Vision 2020, and she got 236 rewards credits.
We don't see any slides.
Oh, shoot. All right. Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on. Share screen.
You went off your magic changing box, and we took the slides with you.
Going back. Here we go.
Here we go. Michelle. All right. There we go. Look at that. She's got Vision. She booked her hotel for Vision and saved $31.28. Way to go, Michelle.
Don't forget the rewards credits.
Oh, 200. Look at that. That's a lot of reward credits. 236 reward credits. Way to go, Michelle. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Is it Christmas yet?
You know what? Stop sharing, please. Stop sharing for 1 second. No, not, I didn't say turn off your video. I meant stop sharing the slide so that people could see your hat. We want to see your hat. We want to see this. Yeah, let everybody see this madness.
Hey guys.
Mm-hmm.
How you doing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is it Christmas yet? Gosh, I hope it's not. I hope we don't know.
You know what, Mark? What? Where did you even get that hat? And I got two questions for you. Number one, where did you get that hat? And number two, why did that take so long?
What?
All you did was change hats. You were gone forever.
Yeah. I don't know. So this is Deb's hat.
Yeah, that is very evident, yes.
Oh, I think it might have been McKenna's. Maybe it was McKenna's.
Yeah, okay. All right. We love you this morning. We appreciate you so, dude. You have made my whole Saturday. It can be Sunday now. I'm good. I've had enough Saturday because of you. I love it every minute of it. Thank you very much.
Mark definitely needs to go outside and get some fresh air. Lack of air is affecting his brain cells.
Yes, please. You are. Yeah. Somebody said he's been locked up at home too long. You most certainly have. Oh, yeah. My God.
Yeah. All
somebody
right.
said, for Mark, every day is Christmas. Christmas. I think you lost, somebody said, oh my God, I think you just lost your title of VP of marketing. Oh no, he has just secured his title of VP of marketing. You want the most creative and crazy one to be your VP of marketing. And guess who that is?
That you?
No, it's not me. I keep the train
all right. Let's get back to this. Ayanna Bailey saved $205.91. 264 rewards credits. Nice. Ayanna.
Way to go, Ayanna. Leon, wow. Look at this. This is big, juicy. $419.44. That's how much Leon saved and got 520 reward credits. And folks, sometimes we lose sight of the big picture. $419. His reservation was $766. So just think about it. If he didn't have the $419 of savings, his reservation would have been over $1,100. Come on, folks. I go for less, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Boom. I get excited. Oh,
you are.
It's me. It's my turn. I'm not used to seeing my face without the tuna corn on top of it. All right. Okay. Well, folks, we've got just a couple of housekeeping announcements that we want to share with you and go over with you. We'll go to the next one here. We'll go to that first announcement and we'll talk about it for you. And the first announcement is that I just want to remind you guys of the generosity that we got to enjoy from our CEO, Holton Buggs, in making the decision to pay the monthly commissions early last week. So, you know, rather than making everybody wait till Monday the 20th, they were paid on Thursday afternoon. And then even that week, that particular week's dual team and fast start bonuses were paid early as well. They were paid on Friday instead of Monday. So, you know, that's just the CEO that we've got. He's got a huge heart for as long as I've known him, for as long as Mark's known him. You know, he is one of the most givingest people on the planet. And I just want you to know, just in our conversations, our executive conversations all week, which have been fun and also have been very serious, your CEO, Holton Buggs, is always, always, always doing things to look out for the Ibüümerang family. All right, let's go to the next one. And so part of that is that we have delayed the annual renewals. So for those of you who've been in network marketing for a while, you know that on every year, on the anniversary of you being in the company, you have to pay an annual renewal. Okay, and the same here at Ibüümerang. That annual renewal is $34.95, and it happens on the anniversary. And some of you have been in for a year, right? Some of you have been in for a little bit longer than a year. And so here's what we're gonna do. Everybody who was in prior to March 11, 2019, we are treating your anniversary as March 11. Okay. And then of course, after that, you've got people who were in on March 12, 13, 14, 15, and so on and so forth. Now, we were originally going to run those on March 20th, but given the situation that the whole world is in, as a consideration, we are delaying the annual renewal until April 20. And we'll continue to watch that and review. And if we need to delay it again, we will. But that's just to give everybody just a little bit of breathing room until that time. And again, that's coming from your CEO. That's coming from the big heart of Holton Buggs. And so we appreciate that very, very much. All right, next up is volume reset. Now, as a huge act of generosity, we have not reset anyone's volume since the beginning. But yet it clearly states in the compensation plan that if you have not done your monthly subscription for any given month, that any stored volume that you have that you've accumulated would reset, right? And we haven't done that, but now it's time to do that. We haven't done it for over a year, believe it or not. But now it's time to actually go ahead and do it. So on Monday coming up, we're going to reset anyone. You know, we're going to reset volume. If you didn't do a February monthly subscription and you didn't correct it during the month of March up through, I think you didn't correct it by March 20th, there's going to be a volume reset. So we don't want you to be surprised. And then going forward, here's how it's going to work. If your monthly subscription does not run in the month it's supposed to run and you don't fix it by the 15th. Now, let me tell you what 15th fixing it means. It means you need to reactivate and you need to let us know so that we can credit that in the month, right? So for example, let's take the month of March. You want to take a look. If your monthly subscription has not run for March, you want to make sure that you fix that by hitting the reactivate button, contacting our customer support team and letting them know that you need some help getting that done. And what you really want to do is try to get it fixed in the month of March, okay? But if you don't fix it by April 15, right? Now, let's suppose that it's April 2nd and that's when you finally get it fixed. You need to let us know so that we can make sure it's credited to the month of March, okay? And you have until the 15th of April to make sure that March is solidly taken care of. If not, your volume is going to reset. And that's how it's going to be every single month. So we wanted to make sure that everybody knew. We wanted to make sure that everybody understood. You want to make sure if you have volume that you've accumulated, you want to maintain that. So you want to make sure that you are doing your monthly subscription every month. You need to monitor that, make sure that you've got a green circle, and all of that is going to be gravy for you. So just giving you guys a heads up, let your teams know. This is why you want to be on flight school, because then you'll miss stuff like this and you'll wonder what happened. All right, next up. Anything else in the T-Gray con? Okay. Yeah, this is another big one I want to talk about. All right, see, I had to get all serious and grown up. IGO refunds. Okay, so if you've booked a trip on IGO, right, you or your customers, during this time, you've got lots of folks that are looking for a refund because they're not able to travel and take their trip. Here's what you need to do. You've got to look at your confirmation, right, and see what your confirmation says under the cancellation policy section at the bottom. So you pull out your email confirmation that you got when you booked your trip, scroll to the bottom, it says cancellation policy. Now, under cancellation policy, it's gonna say one of three different things. It might say refundable. If it's refundable and you cancel your trip, then you're gonna get a cash refund. They're gonna refund it back to your card, okay? If it says partial refund, then you're gonna get a cash refund for the refundable portion. And here's what our partners at IGO are doing that's super cool. They're gonna give you reward credits for the amount of the penalty. They do not have to do that, but they're doing that for our customers and our ambassadors, okay? If it says non-refundable, which means that you got such a great fare or a great deal that it's non-refundable, our partner is still going to give you a refund. It's just not a cash refund. It's going to be reward credits that you could use for future travel, which is the same as cash. It's just that you can't get cash that you can go and use it someplace else. You have to use it on a trip. Now, they don't have to do that because, see, here's what you got to realize, folks, with IGO. You get incredible prices. We just covered all those people who saved money, right? We just covered the person who saved over $400 on their booking, and instead of $1,100, their booking was $700. Well, guess what? That comes at a price. That comes at a trade-off, and the trade-off is flexibility. That's how life works. The airlines do it all the time. If you book a trip on United Airlines, they're going to show you four prices. The first price is the basic economy price. Then it has economy, premium, and first class. And the higher price you pay, the more flexibility you get. But if you book that basic one, it's gonna tell you no refunds. It's gonna tell you you can't change it. It's gonna tell you you have to pay for every bag that you bring, right? In some airlines, you have to pay for your carry-on bag. This is just kind of the way life works. If you go to the clothing store, they often have a rack called clearance, and the items on the clearance rack are drastically reduced. Now, if you go buy something else in the store and you pay full price, it's brand new, it's the latest thing, you'll be able to bring it back and get a refund. But if you buy something from clearance it's going to tell you there's no refunds on the clearance things. The price is so low that the trade-off is if you don't like it when you get home or something's wrong with it, you got to keep it, right? So this, that's just a life principle. You're going to, you get such great deals and access to such great deals on iGo that very often the prices are non-refundable. But even at this time, our partner is so amazing. They love us so much. They see what we're doing. They see the 500,000, actually now 540,000 customers that we brought to the table. And they say, hey, you know, here's what we're going to do for your folks. Even if it's non-refundable totally, or if there's a part of it that's not refundable, we're going to give them reward credits. And understand that that is them giving you real money, because you can actually use those reward credits to book a trip down the road, all right? So that's important for us to remember. Teach that to your teams. Teach that to your teams, because most of us get it. Most of us are doing great with that, but there's a few people who are writing angry letters to them, getting on the phone and being very rude, and that's not the Ibüümerang way. So let's not do that. Let's always be courteous, and also don't charge back. Charging back is such an irresponsible personal behavior, right? It's really rude. And you know, one day if you had a business where you had to get merchant accounts and run credit cards, and if you experienced charging back, you would understand how terrible that is. So don't charge back, because here's what the folks at iGo are going to do if you charge it back: they will permanently close your account. And you will not have access to those discounts, and we can't get you back on if you do that. So don't charge back, accept the reward credits, you know, basically take a look at the terms you agreed to, and they are going to take great care of you. Be patient, be courteous. Lots of businesses are dealing with high volume at this time. They love you, we love you, and we're gonna keep it rocking. All right, I think that's enough on that.
All right.
I like it. I like this note from Peggy. This is huge. Thank you, iGo for Less, for helping us out during this time. That's right. Absolutely. And Brenda on Facebook says reward credits equal real money. Yes. And Jamal said, thank you for covering this. People, I know people didn't know. Please make sure your teams know. And we're going to keep rocking and rolling. All right. Let's see. You guys did amazing. Can I give you guys an update? Can I give you guys an update? Check this out. Check this. This is like just how amazing you all are. We just got a note from Anna. Boom Foundation followers. Can we put that slide back up? The follower, people following the Boom Foundation on Instagram jumped by 100 people within just a few moments, based on the conversation that we were having. Let's put that slide back up, Mark, the Boom Foundation.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And that is really super awesome, guys. I mean, that just shows that you guys are tuned in and really responsive. So guess what? We're at 933 followers on the Boom Foundation right now, and we want to get to 1,000. So let's see if we can get to 1,000 followers of the Boom Foundation on Instagram while we are on this call. There we go. Here come Marcus putting the slide back up for you guys. So you just want to go to @BoomFoundation on Instagram. We're at 933 followers. We were at 833 followers at the beginning of this call. Mark mentioned this to you guys, and you guys, 100 of you already jumped on. So look, people are saying, I just followed. Done. I love it. You guys are absolutely incredible. Let's get the Boom Foundation to 1,000 followers on Instagram right away.
And don't forget Facebook.
Oh, sorry, Facebook too. Wow. Yeah, we're at, I love it. We have the same handle on Facebook too, at Boom Foundation on Facebook. So definitely, guys, let's go ahead and do that. You guys are amazing, and your teams are amazing too.
All right. Let's do this.
All right, so I think we, I don't know, I think we have him. Here we go.
Mr. Buggs, are you on?
And Mr. Buggs, I know that if you're on there, just click on participants, and then there's a thing that says reclaim host. Go ahead and claim the host, because there's two Ibüümerang people using Ibüümerang Zoom that we don't know which one is which. How about we just try making different ones the host? So folks, we've got your CEO, Holton Buggs, on the line with us today, folks. And I tell you what, it's an exciting time that we have. So we got KG. KG, label yourself so we know which one is you. And then by process of elimination, we'll know which one is HB. I think it might be this one.
I can't start because the host.
There you go. You can start. Hey, everybody, your CEO, the one and only, the amazing Mr. Holton Buggs.
I still can't start. Says you can't start your video because the host has stopped it.
All right, we're making you the host right now. You are the host. So you can start. I think, you know what? I think
can't
we are.
Can't start the video because your host has stopped it.
All right, Kitsia, make Holton the host. We've all been trying to make you the host. There we go.
Welcome from Dubai.
Love it. Love it. Good morning, Mr. Buggs. How are you today?
Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Good morning. Hey, listen, I feel I'm so proud of myself. You have no idea why I am so proud of myself. But every day I do something whereas I can say I'm proud of me. And today is one of those days that I can look myself in the mirror, and I'm gonna take me a selfie right now. Just my own selfie, not for the background, but my own selfie.
Uh-huh.
There we go. And I'm gonna say I'm proud of me. I'm gonna tell you why. You guys already know it is difficult for me to set up, or not set up, it's impossible almost, but for me to even send an email outside of my mobile phone, it's like, you know, I've gotta go back to class, all right? And I set this entire thing up with my, you know, my lights, and my downloading backgrounds, all that kind of stuff. I got on the Zoom. I didn't call you guys and ask you how to do it. I'm always bugging Mark, what do I need to do? How do I do it? Every time, right? I did it all myself, and I've got my own background here. I'm actually in Dubai right now. So people say people aren't traveling. BS, I'm in Dubai. So right now, and I may be visiting some other place very, very soon. You guys probably see it when I visit this other place as well. But I did it all myself, so I'm proud of me. So
you know what, Mr. Buggs, we're proud of you too. We're proud of you too. This is like a major moment.
This is major. This is big time. You know, this is big time stuff for me. You know. So
I mean, this is how it starts. I mean, you go from choosing a virtual background today and setting up your lights. Tomorrow, yeah, you're going to be coding.
Listen, I'm telling you, and at first I didn't have my hat. And in Australia, in Dubai over here, they have a boom gear store right down in the lobby of my hotel. And so I saw you had the hat on. I saw Kit Kart had hats on. But they told me in Australia, said they don't allow multicolored hats, over in Dubai. So I couldn't get Mark's hat. The homie don't play that hat. I couldn't get that hat.
So proud.
I know, right? That hat. The homie don't play that hat.
Right. But guess what they have in Dubai at the Boom Gear store that we don't have anywhere else in the world?
They got that red hoodie. And you know that I'm number one for saying, how did you get that?
Hey, I'm telling you. Hey, listen, y'all, I went to the Boom Gear store. I mean, it just, you know, they got a Boom Gear store there. So
I
picked you up another one, T-Gray.
Okay, what you got?
I picked you up one.
Oh, that's nice. Is that a gray hoodie?
It's not gray. It's light gray. It's tea gray. Gray.
Yeah, baby. That's what I'm talking about. I'm super excited.
And this is dark gray.
Oh, my God. Two shades of gray.
Still gray.
We got to have 50 of those. So we can have 50 shades of gray.
So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna have a courier, Tigray.
Okay.
And send them over to you.
Awesome.
Would that be cool?
That would be so fantastic. Yes.
Awesome. Mark, you want one as well?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I didn't include you, Mark, because I was gonna tell Tigray not get out of Dallas. Get out of Dallas? And you think you're getting one of these from Dubai? Get out of Dallas? So right now I'm throwing 50 shades of gray. I'm throwing shade. For some of you who know what I mean by throwing shade, right?
You are throwing shade. You are throwing 50 shades. I got
you. I'm throwing 50 shades, baby.
All right, I see it. Mr. Gray can see it. You get it? Mr. Gray can see it now.
Mr. Gray can see it. Good. I am so glad, right?
Oh, my God.
All righty. Well, welcome, everybody. I know you guys have been having a great flight school. I have, watching these guys, and I actually went and I had a little reset moment, whereas I had to go back and pull out my elementary coloring box of Crayola just to see if I had the same number of colors that Mark had in his hair today. And Mark, they didn't make those type of colors back then, so you got to let me know where you get all of those colors from, all right? I love it. No, guys, this has been absolutely incredible, phenomenal. Flight school, as always, congratulations to all of you who have gotten your all those customers that you've been getting. I mean, it's amazing what's been going on. And, it's really exciting to see the growth that's still taking place. I'm going to talk to you about that today. I want to say to those of you who are here as well, I got to say I champion you and I applaud each and every one of you because we are dealing with some times right now that are unprecedented times. We are all going through something at this moment, and some of us personal, some of us emotional, some of us have been health related, some of it has been, career, job, financial related. Some of us have been in what we call this I don't know zone. Some of us have, in our moments of being by ourselves, we felt alone. We felt confused. We felt fear. We felt probably every emotion that's possible. Some of us have felt all of those. And many of us have felt a few of those, even all at the same time. And, we're never here, myself, T. Gray, Mark, or any of our leaders, here to make light of the effects of it. But we empathize and we sympathize with anyone who has had to endure anything, any loss or whatever it may be. We empathize and sympathize there. One of the things I can tell you is we've got a role here. Ibüümerang has a role, and our role is to lead people through this. And I'm not saying leading Ibüümerang people through it, but to lead people through it. I invite everyone now to our Zoom call with a post that I did yesterday. I had so many people to DM me saying, how can I get on that inspiration call? I mean, Mike Healy yesterday, I think either I had onions, or we were growing some onions outside, my allergies were bad, or he had me at Hello Future Mike. I will not admit that tears were coming from my eyes. It's allergies, if y'all know what I'm talking about. It is such an amazing call, inspired me yesterday to even make that post, you know, because people needed to hear. People need to hear stuff like that. And one of the things I can tell you is throughout every one of those calls, I'm not thinking about the situation, okay? And I know sometimes what happens is people say, well, you know, they mischaracterize, and they sometimes compare people who they feel don't have their problem or their situation, and their situation may be lacking. And they compare others who know that their situation is the complete opposite and say, you don't understand. So maybe, you know, right now you don't see a way financially to pay bills for the next 6 months. And you say, well, somebody else has all of their bills paid. So you say they don't understand. Well, maybe that's the only thing that you've lost, whereas the person who can pay their bills just lost their mother. And no amount of bill money can bring back the mother. And so what I don't want anybody to do is comparing worses. How bad I have it versus how good you have it. Look what I just lost that you didn't lose. Because all of us have something completely different. All of us. You know, it doesn't matter what the category is. It doesn't, you know. Some people have lost their pets. Some people have lost this or lost that or whatever it is. And so we're all going through it. We all go through it. And the bigger your circle, the more opportunities for you to have something that you've actually lost. And it doesn't mean that your losses are bigger. It just means that the bigger your circle, sometimes the more relatable you are to losses, because you're dealing with multiple people who've lost in different ways. And so we deal with it. I've got some very close friends that are really, really, really sick right now. And, you know, and I pray for them every moment. And so anyway, but our job, what's our job? Our job is to shine the light on there's two sides of that coin. And our job is to shine the light on that side of the coin that says there's hope. And that side of the coin that says there is possibility, there is future, there is life. Even after death, there is life. After turmoil or whatever it may be. And there's also life if you're very positive about it. There's more life that's available. And so as a leader, which each of you are, you've got a responsibility as well. And sometimes what we do as leaders is sometimes, even myself as a new leader, I would make emotional responses. And what I mean by that is emotional reactions. Why? I hadn't been trained. And my first thought or my first emotion is what I go with. And what I realize, the more experience that I get, the more mature that I get, the more I need to practice being still for a moment. I have to practice being still. You know, And what I noticed in my moments of being still, my emotions didn't talk to me. And that's the moment, whereas I have my connection on a spiritual level, however it is that you do it, and I allow the universe to just to really direct me in the way that I really should, so that I can be the best leader for somebody possible. You may say, well, I don't have a big group. This is not about Ibüümerang. You got a coworker. Are you the follower in that group, or are you the leader? The person who sits next to you in the cubicle, do they always invite you to lunch, or are you the one who says, hey, listen, it's time to go to lunch. You ready to go? You're the leader. And people are watching you. I just found out late last night, we have one of our team members. I got to reach out today, but one of our team members on our staff, just they lost a grandmother last night, you know, and so it's, but you got to be still. You got to be still, and you can never be in. It's never time as a leader to claim victimhood. You know, what I did yesterday is I made a post on my Instagram. I think I did it on Facebook as well. And I talked, really, the title of it was A New Deadly Virus. That's spreading. It's more deadly than COVID-19 or the coronavirus, it is. And that deadly virus is called negativity. What did I mean by that? Okay. And what I spoke about, and I wasn't planning to talk about this, but you know me, I don't ever plan my talks. What I spoke about was, I spoke about how you don't have to plant weeds. When you look at your garden, all you've got to do is not pay attention to your lawn, not tend to it, not care for it. And what happens is weeds will automatically grow. And when weeds grow in your lawn, in your garden, wherever, and you take a vacation for 6 weeks and you come back, you no longer have a garden. Because what weeds do is seeds of weeds will actually, they'll take the underpinning of the earth and the subterranean, and they'll connect. They'll find ways to connect. What do I mean by that? Let me draw a parallel. Negative people will always find a way to connect with someone else who shares their same emotion because they weren't still. And they'll go below the foundation of the surface. They will union together. And see, when you bond together like this, it's hard to break that bond. See, I with my fingers like this, this is real easy. Real easy. Why? There's no grouping yet. But when I do them like this, if you do your fingers like this and just clamp down and try to pull them apart, I'm really pulling apart. And it's difficult. So those weeds come together down below the surface, they clamp together, and they all have one common denominator. It's to choke the life out of what's positive and take over. And so there's what I call weeds of the mind. Weeds of the mind. And and weeds of the mind are more dangerous. Why? Because it's you can spread it. See, corona, you've got to practice social distancing. There's no social distancing that stops the weeds of the mind from spreading. Because I could send an email of negativity from here all the way to Nigeria, and I can infect a community with my leadership and my negative mindset, and I planted it over there. And then they take that same mentality because I was leading in a negative way, and they spread it over into Russia. And then Russia spreads it over back to Mexico. Mexico sends it to Canada. And here's what happens is that in a matter of hours, that virus has spread all around. And what it does, it kills hopes, it kills dreams. And all of these aspirations that you got, that you, if you remember when you even saw the opportunity or the reason that you saw the opportunity, it's not about Ibüümerang, but there was a reason that you were open because you were looking for something before you found Ibüümerang. Ibüümerang didn't give you a dream. You had a dream in the beginning and Ibüümerang became your vehicle. And what happened is those negative vibes, they bind together and they steal away your initial vibration. They steal away your initial glimmer of hope. And the purpose of that virus is to form a distraction. We had a meeting with the Sapphires and Above, and I told them that it was really about money matters and cash flow management, but this was about hitting the reset button financially. There's certain reasons, in my opinion, that the universe does things like this, and that's just my belief. I don't believe it's like intentional to hurt anyone, but there's a reset button that's hit in many categories, emotional, financially, just economically, politically, socially, whatever it is, there's a reset button that needs to hit. And it happens all the time. It happens all the time. If you go back and pay attention to history, there's always a reset button that hits. And so what happens is you have two groups. You have groups that come together and become more positive, and then you have the naysayers and the down-spirited that actually go out and spread their weeds of the mind. And our job is bringing positive. Our job, somebody's got to do that. That's what that's the role that I'm taking. Somebody's donating their medical expertise because that's their talent. That's not my job. I'm not a doctor. I only can give you rumors when it comes to medical. So that's not my job. If you watch enough programs, you'll see people who are experts who are donating, Dr. Fauci, Dr. Burke, and all of these different doctors and who are on all of these different news channels and stuff like that. They offer expertise and you get facts from them. Political experts who understand how to organize their state or their country or their city or their province. That's their expertise. And so when you have a moment like this, the best of the experts come out to go and do what it is that we do. All right. You have experts in entertainment who are out there right now entertaining. Tigre and I were talking about DJ Nice put on a concert and Michelle Obama got on and next thing you know, all of these celebrities were on and it was the biggest online concert, virtual concert with social distancing. Those are experts, that's what they do. My expertise is teaching the power of belief. My expertise is in financial stewardship. My expertise is redirecting or giving people what I call conscious interruption. You ever heard an object in motion will continue in motion unless it's interrupted by an outside force or object? That is a physics formula that I learned in college. Will continue in motion unless interrupted by an outside force or object. Well, I learned something while I was in college as well. I read a book that was called The Law of Success by Napoleon Hill. It was the unabridged version of Think and Grow Rich. And the first chapter is thoughts are things. Things are objects. So an object in motion, okay? If I threw this chapstick across the room, it will continue in motion unless interrupted by an outside force or object. An outside force that normally will stop this would be gravity. At some point, it's going to drop. Gravity is intercepting. Or my window that's way over there. If I threw it hard enough, the window would stop it, an outside force or object. That's the object, an object. So the book says thoughts are things, things are objects. So a thought in motion, that means if me thinking in a negative direction, that thought is going to continue thinking that way unless intercepted by an outside thought. Unless you sit in front of my seminar or in front of my TV screen, when I'm going to share with you that the way that you're thinking is taking you in a different direction, and I give you a conscious interrupt and I change the direction of your thought process. That's what I do. I'm not a travel sales. I haven't sold a vacation. I haven't sold a hotel room since we've been in Ibüümerang. And I'll get to that part as well. I haven't gone up to anyone with you know, we finally got brochures, but I still haven't gone up to a person with the brochure and say, look, here's a big discount. Let me sell you on this room. Here, I know you weren't thinking about going anywhere, but you should go because the price is so low. No. I'm a conscious interrupter. How? I have personal customers. My customers think that retail online travel is the only way to buy. And this is what they've done for 20 years. And I interrupt them. I throw a boomerang and it interrupts their thought process. Wow, there's a way for me to have a membership? And I just connect them that way. Because I already know some of us on this call have listened to people who say, ooh, nobody's traveling now. Why would you do Ibüümerang? Why should I continue working? You're on this call, you joined a travel company? If you joined a travel company, you pay too much. Or actually, you didn't pay enough because travel companies are very expensive to join. Okay? Hopefully you saw a vehicle. You saw a franchise. You saw a system that allows you to utilize something called a PRIB so that you could get from point A to point B much faster than your 9-to-5. Okay? So I even had industry experts call me and say, Holton, hey man, you know, I've had people start sending me vitamins. They sent me pictures of their vitamins saying, man, you should really, this is the time to boost your immune system, taking advantage of a situation. And they don't mean any harm, but it's irresponsible. They have no evidence. They don't know for a fact that that vitamin is going to work for me. They have zero evidence, but they listen to all that. Here's an opportunity for me to make money because people are in a panic moment. And I don't blame them. It's just what they do. But I've got evidence that what I do works. We show evidence 100% of the time. Over 70% of the people who take a nutritional supplement, doesn't even absorb properly in their bodies. And we still sell them because they're not experts and they don't even know any better. And I'm not here putting vitamin companies down. One day our crib will have something for nutrition. It just won't be expensive. We're going to sell our crib can do anything. Okay? And I tell you this, what would you pay to clear out the weeds of your mind? A gardener, many of you, if you saw your weeds in your garden, you call a gardener or a landscaper and you'd go, hey, listen, get some weed eater or whatever it is. And I need you to take care of my lawn. Why? Because you like to look out and see a pretty garden. And some of you are so concerned about what your neighbors think about your yard. You'll spend $200 to $300 just to make sure your neighbors don't think that you can't afford a landscaper. Because you've got weeds in your garden. But how many of you would actually invest in the weed eater or the landscaper up here? How many of you would invest in the person who's going to eliminate and help you eliminate the weeds here? This is how I want you positioning yourself, and this is how I want you thinking. You are part of this positive organization that has the ability to redirect the thinking of a few people. Don't try to save the world because it's a way for you to be grossly disappointed. But what you can do is you can impact anybody who's close to you, anybody within your proximity, you can give them a conscious interrupt and move their thinking in a whole new trajectory, a whole new pattern of thought process. That's what we do. That's what you really bought. But if you knew what you had access to, and if we really packaged it the right way, I couldn't have most of you on this call because most of you really couldn't afford it. You couldn't. It's not saying that, it's just facts. I pay a lot of money. I mean, a lot. And close to six figures a year now to be a part of a very special group, small group of people. And they don't charge me the money because they need the money. They charge the money so that each person, okay, even though these people are highly successful, so that they don't take it for granted and spoil the group. See, every time we have a meeting, it's this small organization of people. Most are CEOs. A few are multi-billionaires. And I'm so fortunate that they saw value that I could bring to the group. You pay the money so you can add value, not so you can go and sit there and soak up everything and just get it, get. No, you pay money so you can come and bring it. And I pay money so that I could be there. And the reason that they charge is because let's imagine it's only 20 of us. And all 20 of us say, oh, we paid $1,000 and only $100 a month to be a part of this group. They'll have another meeting next time. And you know what we'll do? We'll miss it. What's the value of that group now? Being that every time this new person who's on there, or now when I need the information and I've been given and I go to our meeting and 18 of the 20 didn't show up because it's an option for them, the value of that group and the information totally diminishes because there's absence there. But when you're knowing that you're paying six figures, you show up on time and you don't miss. But this is the way successful people think. Another conscious interrupt. And so I'm there and I understand, and I've had so many conscious interruptions by being a part of this group. Why? Because many of the people are much older than I am. Some are younger than I am. Many of them are, the majority of them, a lot of them are much, 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 much more successful than I am. When you're the smartest person in the room, you better get a new room. Smartest person in the group, you better get a new group. Okay? And so I come back and I feed my team, and the six figures that I pay a year is minuscule in terms of the return. It's so small. So small. Yeah? So small. And some of you, whether you even know it or not, you've got access to this group and you don't even know it. Why? Because I'm not selfish. I don't go to the grocery store if I've got, you know, if I've got family and friends at my house, I don't go to the grocery store. T-Gray and Mark are here and Tunde and Ed are here. I'm not going to the grocery store and grabbing one steak, knowing that they're back here. If I go to the grocery store, I'm going to the grocery store, I'll call back Buggs. Hey, listen, how many people do we have at the house? Okay, you, T-Gray, Ed. Okay, oh, Sam Bean is over. Kim Bean is over. Tunde's over. Mark's over. Oh, Bernstein's on his way. Okay. So let me grab not only enough steaks for them, I'm grabbing a few more steaks just in case two or three more people come. Why? I gotta feed my people. That's how I roll. How you do anything is how you do everything. So when I go to my meetings and I attend my meetings, we've been having some online ones, I go there and I bring it first. I make deposits. When they say, who's ready to share? I'm hitting the raise my hand button now and let me share. They know everything that we're doing right now. They know this conference call. They know the Boom TV. I'm talking billion. They know what you're doing. And they're sitting there like, wow, I'm so grateful. Nobody ever thought of this. And they implement it yesterday. That's the thing I love about successful people, to implement. And I give my deposits, and you know what I do when I give my deposit? I shut my mouth and I take out my little pen and I listen for what they're about to give. Why? I deposited one. I've got 19 other deposits that are going to be made, and I can withdraw 19 times more than I deposited. And I listened to what he said and what she said and what they did and how they did this and how they did that and how they did that and what they did over here. And I'm taking it down and I can't. And as soon as they put something in the chat, boom, I send it off to my executive group, T-Gray, Mark, and Ed, and you know, just some of our, I'll fire it on off right away. Well, I got to feed them. I got to feed them. And then they take that information and they incorporate it in their minds. And part of what they talk about is going to be how they disseminate information through the call. And if you're on this call and you know the value of who you're in business with, you should be saying, I'm getting information from a meeting that I can't even afford to be in. Why? Because I'm with the right people. That's the way I want you to look at what it is that you're involved in. Okay? Ibüümerang and Vibe, it just happens to be the way that people will exchange money for the technology or a benefit, and you get to earn the money. The biggest value of what it is that you have is access. It's access. But some of us, see, you don't call your landscaper to come treat the weeds if you can't recognize weeds. Some of you look out in your garden and say, wow, man, look at that flower. It's growing pretty fast. Honey, did you plant a new flower out there? It's growing all, but it's all over the place. And you come back next week, wow, man, what is that? Is that a beanstalk? You haven't been educated that those are weeds. See, some of us who have been negative can identify that what you say is negative. Why? Because you do it all the time and it's normal. It's normal. And so you don't even know to come to the call so that you can put yourself in the way of conscious interruption. You don't even know I need a weed eater to go ahead and eliminate these weeds. Now, see, my landscaper, I can go pull the weeds. I can pull them. And if I pull the weeds, guess what happens? They come right back. Why? Because I didn't get to the root of the problem. I can trim them, cut them, but my landscaper has gone to school. They understand. Thelma understands how to get down and put some stuff. Just don't worry about them. I don't have to chop them down. I've got some stuff that I'm going to put in your grass. Weeds can't stand it. And the weeds will die away. But if you don't know that they're weeds and you think that they're flowers, guess what you'll keep doing? You'll water them with more negativity. More and more. And your job as well as my job, don't you forget it. You got to understand what your role is, what you do, and you may have additional specialties. But as far as this is concerned, your job is to put the weeds out and spread that there's hope, spread that there's excitement, spread that there's life, spread that whatever the positive is, that's your job. That's what your role is. And don't you ever forget it. Don't get this twisted. Don't get this all mixed up thinking, oh, I just in the travel business and I send the boomerangs. Every boomerang feeds someone. Go back and listen to my address that I did in Vegas of why I started Ibüümerang, why I named the company Ibüümerang. If you don't know, you need to understand why you're here, because if you don't have a mission of spreading love or giving away goodwill, I'm going to be very candid with you. You need to become a customer or you need to quit, because you're going to disappoint yourself. If your goal is the opposite of spreading goodwill, this is the wrong company for you. You're going to disappoint yourself, because we are going to inundate you with goodwill. Go back and understand. Guys, that's not stage talk of why I started this company and named it Ibüümerang. It's the real deal. Okay? So understand that. Understand that. Now that I'm off of my soapbox, okay? And I have to get off of my soapbox. Because I get on these calls and I have no idea what I'm going to talk about, what I'm going to say. Honestly, I don't. Sometimes I do, you know, when I have my slides or whatever it is, I have an idea what I'm going to say. But anyway, I got to come talk to my people, you know, and I'm not a politician, so I'm not going to paint a picture. I'm not going to paint one of these pictures so that you can reelect me. Okay. I don't get elected. Okay. And so, and I'm not here to buy votes. I'm here to just give it like it is. I like my grandma used to say, give it like it T.I. is. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about, okay? My Australians right now probably don't know what that is. But anyway, just ask someone. Ask T. Gray. Mark don't even know what give it like it T.I. is. He don't even know what that is. but anyway, I'm a little distracted here because my whole screen, I'm going to show y'all what my whole screen has been like here. Okay. You guys want to know what a real timeout is? This is what my whole screen looks like right now. I'm going to show you guys this. The whole time I've been talking, this has been my screen. That's been my screen. Just like that, he has been frozen in timeout for at least however long I've been talking. Okay? I got you in timeout. Is that been your, okay, now it's changed. Okay, thank you.
How do you have me on perpetual timeout?
It's the prep.
Perpetual timeout machine.
Mm-hmm. Perpetual recess interruption button. The prep.
Oh my God.
So, but anyway, guys, here's something that's cool that we're going to do this week, and I'm really excited about it. Really excited about it. But I don't know why he's in timeout again on my screen. Mark, get him off of my screen right now. Just get him off of my screen. Say something, Mark, and then mute him. I don't want to. There you go. I'd rather watch my boomerang.
It's just your screen. I mean, everybody is seeing you.
Okay, that's what it is. Okay, now hold on for a second. Let me see if I can do something pretty cool here. Hold on 1 second. I'm gonna go somewhere. Boom. You see that?
Yes. Do what you that's love. Fire.
We like that.
Do what you love.
What?
We are. I'm like mind blown impressed.
What? Listen. Hey.
Like you got more than one?
Do I have more than one?
You have more than one, and you know how to change it.
I got. Listen, I've got one for the Vibe Rides people as well. Boom! We're about to put cars on the road, baby. Hold on.
Mark, he knows how to change it mid-broadcast.
Hey, oh, no. Thanks to your GMA, Edwin Haynes was actually on his way over here. Believe it or not, because I was like sweating bullets. I was like, man, I gotta have my green screen because I don't want to turn this thing on and my screen is green. And Edwin was on his way over here and we were able to get it done. So anyway, so Mark, hold on. Look out for this photo I'm about to send you, Mark.
Okay.
Let's see here. Because I don't know if you were putting some of these things up real quick when I'm going to talk about what I'm going to do. And it may be too late anyway.
Nope.
So, I just checked my phone and I just got one here. Hold on. All right. I don't know. So if it doesn't apply, don't worry about it, but I'm sending it to you anyway.
Okay. I got
okay.
It.
Okay. Anyway. So.
Are these, and the one that we sent, and the ones from last night too?
I don't know. I requested some from them, from her, and I just woke up and I got this right now.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so here's the thing, guys. We are, you know, these calls that we've been doing have been incredible. And, excuse me here, my face feels greasy here. You know why? I've got all these lights over here and getting a little warm and, you know, I also feel like I've been a Baptist preacher for the last 30 minutes. So I need my handkerchief.
I can't take it.
Where's my makeup? I can't. My makeup crew's not here because we have social distancing rules. So I look better now. Look, I don't look as shiny. Okay.
Hey, Mark, I'm sending you that second one again.
Somebody said, pass the collection plate. Okay. So now, but anyway, a couple things that I wanted to mention is how many of you have been liking Boom TV? I need to see it in the chat. If you really have been enjoying Boom Television, you know, I need to see it in the chat. I've got my Facebook up so I can see your response there. And I've got Zoom up and I can see them on Zoom as well. Okay. Cause I've got some, if I see enough loves and likes, I got something for you. Okay. Okay, I got something for you. By the way, if you have not, amongst all the calls, we had introduced another channel, another channel, or maybe it's not a channel, but it's a broadcast of our Vibe Rides calls, 11 o'clock Central Standard Time, where you have been getting updates from our Executive Vice President, Scott Bachlin, and Angela Olivito, and Frederick Brim Brown have been there doing these calls, and it's been really, really good information. And it's going to be a library, obviously a training vault. It's very detailed or very specific. I don't want to say it, very specific training with regard to Vibe Rides and giving the updates. People also ask, hey, listen, given the climate of what's happening at Rideshare, you guys still going to launch? Yes. Actually, it's been, from a timing standpoint, this couldn't be better for us. It just seemed like, this is not, the purpose for everything happening is not for us to have a successful launch, by the way. But right now, this is prime time for a new player to come in Rideshare. As things subside, a new player comes in. And like I said, it's a reset button. And so we just look at things differently. We look at opportunities versus the obstacle. Both exist, and in your mind, you have to choose which one you want. Now, so I'm really excited about Vibe and what's going on. Some pretty cool stuff. It's gonna be huge. And people ask all the time, is Vibe gonna come to your country? It is. I can tell you it's gonna come. Vibe, our goal is to take Vibe all over the world, okay? And I want you to understand what Vibe really is. It's a logistics solutions company. What I mean by logistics, some of you may not know the depths of that term. Logistics simply means the ability of getting something from one place to the other. How am I going to ship this? How am I going to move this? Those are what's called logistics, okay? And so we design our technology as such that if we wanted to deliver, somebody wanted this cup of coffee and it needed to be over here, we design our technology so that this coffee can get over there. Okay. What I mean by that is somebody can get it and deliver it there. We have the ability to do almost anything we want, with our technology. So it's really cool. It's robust. Our tests for quite a while will be passengers. Okay. That's how we test it. I want to share one thing with you real quick with regard to all of this as well. Is so that in the beginning of a business, when you're building a business, and this goes back to those of you who have been challenged by people who say, well, travel is not something everybody's doing right now, okay? And first of all, it's not true. I think so far this month, how many customers have activated Ibüümerangs in this month? Over 40-something thousand? I still got T-Grace.
Correct.
Okay. 40-something thousand customers have downloaded Ibüümerangs. We can't force them to download. They know that they're going to travel. Matter of fact, the only reason we don't have more is because some of you bought the story of the weed, the person who gave you the weed. Well, I'm not going to send a Ibüümerang now because nobody's going to travel. You don't know when they're going to travel anyway. Some people have to travel even during this time, okay? So it's not your job to make up your mind when they're going to travel. It's your job to send the Ibüümerang, send the goodwill. Just don't even think of it as sending a Ibüümerang. Just think of it as, you know what? These kids need to be fed. Let me send the Ibüümerang. Boom, send the Ibüümerang. We feed the kid and let the person make up or determine whenever they're going to travel. That's one of the things we prejudge for people all the time. It's one of the reasons when I got in network marketing, I didn't make money. I prejudged thinking they already have a home because I lived in an apartment. They already have a new car because I had a hoopty, a used car. They already have nice clothes because I bought mine from the Goodwill. So I'm thinking they don't want this business because I'm thinking that the only reason someone should want my business are for the reasons I wanted my business. I wanted to get out of the hood. I wanted to have a nice car. I wanted to buy clothes that were from a store versus from the Goodwill. And so if I saw somebody who wasn't, I judged them on their success and penalized me for my lack of success. Do you see why I only made 500 bucks in a month? That's the reason. It was the weeds. Those were weeds in my mind. Those weeds. Oh no, he's successful. Show me the opportunity. That's why I'm successful, because I pay attention to opportunities. That's what. That's who you send the boomerang to. That's who you send the I decide to. Somebody who loves options. Somebody who's looking for opportunity. Well, I would show them the business, but it's not the right time. You know, with Corona going on, they're thinking they're at home. They're sitting at home saying, oh my goodness, I've overspent. I was so trying to impress my neighbors. I overbought this house. I spent $1,000 too much. And now I don't know if I'm going to be able to afford this extra money. And those all of those cars I bought it really for them, because I'm thinking that I wanted to impress all of these other people. I need an income source. This is the time you should send out the I decide. I'm telling you, I know the real truth, guys. I'm just being honest with you. I know the real truth. Under those garages, you don't have a bunch of Jackie Pippins and a lot of Tawanas with paid off cars. You got a lot of extremely high car notes, and I'm not anybody's judge. I'm just saying they're sitting at home now. They're like, man, you better give them an opportunity. Don't prey on that. Don't call them and say, hey, listen, I know that you're struggling. No. I call up a buddy and I say, hey, man, listen, how's it going? Just checking on you, making sure everything's good, and sincerely checking on them. And how are you in the family? Man, you know what? We're doing good. We're really, really doing good. We're really doing good. Man, how are you in the family? He says, oh, man, you know what? I have to say, man, you know what? We're really concerned about some people. But overall, man, you know, it's been good. I've been working harder now and more now with everything going on. And I'll tell you, man, I'm so grateful that I did some things when I didn't have to, so that I don't have to stress as much now. You know, just having conversation, you kind of know what I mean. He says, man, to be honest with you, I didn't. It was my way of finding out. Okay. And I say, well, you know, talk to me. What's really going on? Is it medical, personal, financial? He says, well, you know, right now, just a little financial uncertainty. I said, you know, I understand. I've been there. I'm empathizing, sympathy. I've been there before. I have. And so I can tell you that there's always light at the end of the tunnel. Man, I can tell you right now, I've got some people that were in your situation, just like mine, and right now who are not in that situation anymore. Right now, this is the time that they're capitalizing on other opportunities. And if you're open to putting yourself in that position, let me know. I've got some information I'll send you. Sure. What's your email address? Boom. I decide. That's how I work it. That's how you do it. Don't take advantage. Don't use fear tactics. Don't scare people. Okay. But this is the time people are looking. All right. This is the time people are looking. You're right. Somebody put something in the settings there. Janet Woodham, if a new iPhone came out right now, social distancing would be a thing of the past at the Apple store, because you'd be packed like sardines waiting for the brand new iPhone. Okay. And so this is opportunity. Also, let me just share something with you, since we've gotten the weeds out, so you can think differently. What I want for you is I want you to be in a position later on, so that, because this is going to happen again. I'm not saying Corona. It's not about Corona. This will happen again. It happened with Y2K. It happened with SARS. It happened with Ebola. It happened with Hurricane Harvey. It happened with Hurricane Katrina. It happened. If you go back and look at history, go back and pay attention to what's happened, and go back also and look at the market, the economy of what happened. It happens every election cycle as well. Every time. I'm not saying this is political. I'm just giving you facts so that you can understand. You know that group I'm a part of? There's some very wise people in there who show us the data of what's happened the last 50 years that they've been in business and how they position themselves, who are no smarter than you and me, and they position themselves to be some of the wealthiest people in the world. When you want that information, it happens all the time. And right now, there's so much activity and transactions that are taking place. So understand money, that money, nobody has taken the US currency or the euro or the yen or the, you know, the peso or the pound. Nobody's taken currencies and go and burn them up. So money has not disappeared. Okay. What I want you to know that's taking place is that you've got some markets that have been what I call overinflated or inflated. I don't want to say overinflated. Inflated. It's a digital amount. So when you see stock market drop, it's that means that belief drop, confidence. The higher the stock market represents the level of confidence that a particular area has. So if you're talking about the New York Stock Exchange, it represents the confidence of the investors and of primarily the United States outside of the outside investors. When confidence is strong, value is there, but nobody burns the currency or the money. What happens is that it exchanges hands. So me with low confidence, I give my asset to this person with high confidence, but because I have low confidence, I give them my asset at a discount. I'm uncertain, but she's been trained to be certain, so she'll pay for my asset lack of confidence. Let me give you a prime example. I was going to sell a couple of my cars because it just, you know, driveway, just, I was going to sell a couple of cars. These are some, you know, not new cars, but some of my older ones that I actually like them better. I got a Range Rover, like a 2008 Range Rover and a 2012 or 13 G-Wagon. And this Camaro that I have, and I was going to just get rid of them. I was supposed to get rid of them like months ago, and I just didn't. You know, because I just got the Vibe Mobile and don't have anywhere to park all these things. So I was going to get rid of them. Do you know, I had my brother take them up there, and then Tunde took one, and he told me what they were going to give me for it. And Tunde said, well, let me just put it on the internet. Okay. So Tunde went yesterday because my brother's power washing our driveway and all this stuff. He wants to get rid of the cars. He calls the guy, says, listen, I'm going to bring the car up. He says, well, right now I'll give you 40% of what I offered you last week. So let's say if he offered me 20,000, okay, it's a 40% discount. So if he offered me 20,000, he's going to take 40% off of 20,000. Why? Because sellers are uncertain and I have to trade my asset to him at a discount, which means money exchanges hands. So what does that mean? I'm using this as an example. If I was in fear or I had to, it's not just about fear or uncertain, and I had to sell my car, I would sell him or her my car. And do you know what he knows and why would he buy it? Because he's experienced and he knows the market comes back. And when the market comes back, whether it's 1 month or whether 2 months or 3 months, he knows he just made 40% more on a vehicle because of my uncertainty. That's what goes on. So put yourself in the position of certainty so that when times do come, you have something in capital that you can go out and utilize and put yourself ahead. It's not taking advantage, because if I'm uncertain and I need to sell that car, I'm hoping I have a buyer. I don't think he's taking advantage of me, okay? I'm hoping he has a buyer. It's supply and demand. He knows that many people are selling cars right now, which means it's a buyer's market, prices of cars go low, supply and demand. And this is just, I'm teaching you economics so that you can understand what's happening around you, that this is not just travel. So why right now put yourself in position in business and travel? Prices are low, which means if, how many of you, I had a Sapphire and Above meeting with the leaders, and I told the Sapphires and Above, part two, I sent the message out. They asked me, HB, what should I invest in right now? You are an Ibüümerang expert. I can't tell you that you're a stock market expert or a real estate expert, or you know how to trade with this or that, but you're an Ibüümerang expert. And many of you have groups at a distance. If I was them, I would take this extra money that I have, and I showed them how to get what I call, I showed them how to free up capital. I'm not gonna do that on this call. Get with your upline, Sapphire, Ruby, or Emerald. And if you qualify, they'll teach you what I taught them. And I said, take this money, call your hotel that you've been doing business with before, who wants $600 for the room to do opportunity meetings. Call them and say, hey, listen, I want to do a 6-month contract with you. And I want to have a, it's called a force majeure clause, that if social distancing or this corona still exists, I want to be able to move my dates and book your hotel rooms and say, hey, I'm willing to commit for 6 months. And instead of you charging me $600, I want it for $250 per meeting. Let me ask you a question. How many of you plan to be doing meetings when you can get back outside? Why not? See, because that hotel is saying nobody's booking. Supply, demand, value is low. You go in and buy it now, 6 months times four, that's 24. In this example, that's 24 meetings. You save $300. That's almost $7,500 of savings that you put in your pocket. This is how you get ahead. What do you do with that $7,500? You invest it back into your business again, and you keep multiplying it. This is all I did. This is what I did. I would book my airline tickets. If I know I'm gonna travel, I book this ticket, this ticket, this ticket, this ticket, this ticket. Why? If I can get them 70% off now and they will allow me to change my dates, I'm already planning for which markets I'm going to when we lift. Why? It's gonna lift, but I can get it cheaper, save me some money, and put that money to work for me. Okay? This is why I told, this is why I've told several people, book your Vegas stuff. Billy and Cynthia Cook. As soon as I said that, I love students who act right now. They called me, they sent me a text. HB, thank you for the information. We booked our hotel and our airline tickets for me and Billy for $350 total. Airline tickets plus their hotel for Vision for $350. Okay? So what if that $350 is what they're paid? Now, this is the equivalent of you trying to play the stock market, put $350 into the stock market and have it triple. Because that normally would have been probably $1,000 for them. But they basically saved $650, which means they tripled their investment. I just want you guys to understand, this is how wealthy people get ahead, okay? A good friend of mine right now is buying real estate, making offers on multi-million dollar homes in Los Angeles, 50 cents on the dollar. Why? Because he knows that a lot of those people bought them to impress their neighbors and they can't afford them. And he says, people are responding and getting in negotiations with them. And this guy is a gazillionaire, and he lives in a house that's probably, his house is probably maybe $300,000-$400,000. And I'm talking about a guy who's making over $20 million a month. But he says, from a foreign country. He says, I'm not here to impress anybody, but I know that there's a lot of people who do. So when times come that are bad, I keep my money. And I buy off their fear. I trade. And this guy is just crushing it. But you can do it starting small. Hopefully you understand that. Now, anyway, so let me finish up and so we can get off of this call here. You guys, you know, I get excited. I just get pumped. I get pumped about creating opportunity. I get pumped about success and projects and certain things. I mean, I've got my team right now. We are looking for real estate right now. I mean, like crazy, all right? Why? It's that time. Now remember, don't judge me because you say, oh, I don't have money. He's got, no. Put yourself in position, okay? Don't judge what you don't have against what I do have. Why? You don't know, you weren't here when I was going through foreclosure. You weren't here when I would pull up at the house on the corner at the stop sign and look to the left and see if the porch light was still on, which was an indicator of whether or not they turned my lights off. And I'm so glad there was somebody I could listen to who didn't have my same problem, because some people are looking for people who have their same problem so they can get together in weeds and talk about how bad it is. But there were people out there who was talking about how to build. And I never forget my first one, Edwin Haynes and I, we didn't even know each other at that time, but it was a guy named Carlton Sheets who talked about buying money, buying real estate, no money down. Okay. And I did. I listened to everything that he was talking about, never bought one property. But you know, the thing I got from him was positive mental attitude. I read all of that stuff and I went through the system, and the next thing you know, I thought I was buying a real estate course. What I bought was a weed eater. And then I found my next opportunity and I put myself in position and I stopped buying brand new cars. Didn't buy any more brand new cars because they came and repossessed my Lexus. And I said, the next one I buy, they can't come and get. So I bought an old Lexus. Never forget, paid $17,000 cash for it when I got back. Said, they can't come get this one. And I bought used cars. My first Rolls Royce, used. I didn't start buying brand new cars until my money that I was making off of my money could buy the car for me. I don't buy cars off of my efforts. I buy it off of my money's efforts, which is another course we'll teach you at Sapphire Splash when we get to Money Matters, okay? So you want somebody who can show you what it's like if you get yourself in position. Stop wanting your leaders to show you how bad they have it so they can join you. No, stretch yourself and say, I know I screwed up before. Won't do it again. With this reset button, I'm changing my thinking, changing my finances, changing my strategy, and I want to be where they are because I'm looking at some of my screw-ups that I did. I'm looking at them right now, okay? And I look at my guys in my group, and I'm like, that's where I'm going to be. And I'm, you know what? I'm taking my people with me. Who wants to come with me? This is why I want you to go diamond. I want you to have liquid cash flow. Why? I'm connected to some people who know stuff that I don't know, and I'm going to take my people. I'm not going to the grocery store buying one steak, coming back. This is why, okay? This is why. And so hopefully you put yourself in position and do some small things. And when you do the small things, you'll get addicted to small victories. And remember, base hits is what win, not home runs. Every property that I bought has been most, I've had a couple of home runs, but most of them are base hits, small profits, small profits, small profits, small profits. And I just had one and it was great timing. Why? Because I programmed myself to have great timing. Sold a building in Canada. I own 40% of my last company. You guys know my company, Organo. I own 40% of that corporate headquarters. Yeah, we just sold it. Big, huge profit. And sold it for $2 million over the value, the assessed value, okay? And it was a huge profit that we made off of it. So why? Because I made some different choices with my money a while back. Make different choices with it. Okay, now taking that, think I'm gonna go spend it? No. What else can I buy? What can I gobble up? It's a game and it becomes fun. It's not about greed. It's about making sure you leave a legacy. And I wanna show you guys how to do some of that stuff. So don't look at it as, this is not bragging about what our leaders are doing. I'm showing you what the path can be for you, okay? for every one of you who choose to be in a path like that. Okay. But I get excited. I look for people that I can share victories with. And sometimes you can't because people, oh, you're trying to brag. No, you want to share victories. I tell you, when I talk to Edwin Haynes, man, and I was talking with Cesar Munoz, and he's telling me what he's doing is, yeah, I've got this property over here, and we're going to buy this. I'm building another apartment complex. He owns this. He owns all of the stuff he owns. We talk about buying land and all of this stuff. And Jose Luis, he's got companies here, stuff he owns over here, stuff over there. And I was on the phone with Johnny. He says, man, listen, let me know, bro. You know, I already trust you. He said, I'll do this networking thing, but if you got something great, I'll just throw some money over there with you. We'll talk about it. But let's see, don't you want to be a part of those clubs? Don't you? On the phone with T. Gray Mark, hey, here's what we need to do. Here's, and showing up, hey, here's what you do to get ahead. Here's what, hey, not only our the distributor, but our corporate team. Here's what I want you to do. And we're doing it. And it's exciting. And it's just, it's amazing because we have time now and the opportunity is available. So here's what we're going to do for you on Boom TV. Here's what we're going to do. Thought about something. And what we want to do is this. Boom TV has been cranking. Our analytics has been phenomenal in terms of our data analytics that we have. And Mark, don't put it up on the screen until I say so. All right?
I'm just ready. Getting ready.
All right. So, but anyway.
Figure.
That's right. So here's what we're doing. Here's what we've been doing. We've looked at our data, and I got to tell you, first of all, ladies, you are kicking the guys' butt big time, okay? Our ladies are our primary audience right now, and you're hungry, okay? You are hungry. The data tells us, okay? The data lets us know the real deal. And girl, that's right, hashtag girl power right now. Give it up for these ladies over here. You're kicking the guys' butts. They're slacking a little bit. And we're going to see what those guys can do. But you guys are doing a rock solid job. I was looking at the data, and it's like, you know, on the meter, the girls are here and the guys were like here. And it's like, wow, they're not even close. It's like the ladies are just rocking, right? So awesome job to you. It Takes Two has been rocking. Keep It Takes Two up. This is a philosophy. This is why you should do it. Cesar Munoz told me they had a Super Saturday, a virtual Super Saturday, over 1,000 people. And tomorrow they're having one. I think Edwin Haynes is going to be on. I'm going to be on. Over 3,000 people expected to attend. 3,000. And it's probably 2,000 of them are women. Okay. Girls have been rocking. Volume are, as a company, I want to share this with you as well. Real numbers. Our volume is actually slightly above where we were last month. For those who are saying, oh, your travel company is down. No. Now, are we down in comparison to what we were expecting? Yes, because we were looking for this huge, because we came out of Accelerate and we were about 80 to 90% higher over last month with recruiting, with volume and stuff like that. And yeah, it took a little dip and then it started going back up. Why? Because people start to realize I can't control when people travel. I just know that I can show them how to save. Okay. And so congratulations to you. It's business as normal. We put business as usual. We put Boom TV back up and the calls have been phenomenal. Presenters are bringing the best out of them and it's just been rocking. So keep that up. But also we've been training you. We've been doing leadership trainings. We've done Keys to the Vault trainings. We have been doing Vibe trainings. We've been doing Travel Tip Tuesdays with Lori. We've been doing conversations with entrepreneurs, basic training. We've been giving you so much so that you don't miss a beat. But we always say, hey, this is our family. We're not just about how many you can recruit. We're not just about how many you can train. We want you to keep those calls rocking. And this week we're adding another channel, and we're going to be adding a little more. And this Boom TV thing will stay at some capacity even after whatever takes place. I think situations bring the best out of us. So coming this week, there's two channels that we're going to add, okay, to our Top Gun University, or what I call our Boom TV. We want to make sure that many of you are at home right now and you can't go anywhere else but be home. And we know that. And we care about you as a person, not just your volume and your boomerangs. We care about you as people. So this week we will be introducing starting on Monday, we will start to introduce our Boom Fit television channel that we have. We've got, it's going to be 3 to 4 different trainers. Our first two trainers are who we have on the screen right now. Emile Mosley will be our trainer on Monday. Alex will be our trainer on Tuesday. We have other trainers that will be coming in as well. And so in the morning, this will take place 1 hour before the inspirational call, okay? I know some of you are saying it's early, but they're going to do a 20-minute workout. You don't need to go buy anything or whatever it is. They're experts. This is what they do for a living. So this is not just a couple of people. They do it. Why? We want to, guys, listen, we got to go to this beach. This beach is calling us, okay? And so I want to see you looking nice and fit and healthy. And they're going to take us through workouts, and I'm going to be on there, and T. Gray is going to be on there, and Mark cannot be visible, period. Mark, if I see you in workout gear and your camera's on, it's timeout. I'm letting you know right now. We're not having it, okay?
Okay. Unless he's wearing like a parka.
Yes. Yes. Actually, right. Mark, I want you wearing a bomber jacket. Do not, you come back with no shirt. There you go. Right. Cover it up, Mark. Right? There you go. That's how I want you on Mondays, okay? So here's what we want you to do, guys. Find you an area in your house. They're going to be at their house. Nothing fancy. We don't want you to think that you got to spend more money unless you just want some Boom gear to work out in. They'll be in Boom gear. All of them will be in Boom gear. They know Ibüümerang. They're very familiar with our culture and Ibüümerang. I've known them for years. Matter of fact, Alex used to be Earlene and Trey's trainer until he moved over to Los Angeles or Las Vegas and had babies and stuff like that. Now he's coming back. We're also going to have yoga as well, okay? We're going to have a yoga session that will be in there. We'll forecast to you what each session will be about, and it's going to be exciting because we want you guys waking up empowered, and we don't want you to miss a beat. You can't get to these gyms. Some of you don't want to go outside. You can do it right from the house. Get your bottled water. Make sure you have your Boom gear jug or whatever it is, or your Vibe bottle, water bottle. And we'd love for you guys to be in your Boom gear, your Vibe gear when we do this, and you'll see all the screens, and they're good. They're really good. They're motivated. They're positive people. It's going to be really exciting. So that's one channel that we're going to do. And that will start out on Monday. So we will go Monday through Fridays on that. And number two, second thing that we're going to do is coming up this week here. Actually, it will take place tomorrow. Starting tomorrow is EB and myself will do a session that's called From Our Home to Yours. Nothing about Ibüümerang. We're just going to sit and have a fireside chat with our people and talk about life, talk about whatever it is that comes either through on the chats, comes through whatever it is, just however it comes to us, we're just going to have those conversations and talk about just stuff. And we want you to just come, and we want to come into your living room. We want to bring our hearts and our spirit into your home and be with you and talk with you and whatever it is. And that's going to be 4 o'clock, I believe, PM on Sundays that we'll do from our home to yours. And if you want to sit there and have your, you know, your coffee or your whatever it is, or your little glass of wine, if you want, you can do that if you want to. And that's going to be really, really, really good. I can't wait for that session. so that we can, I don't want you to feel that you're alone. We want you to feel that you've got friends that you can talk to, and some of you can't have company. And guess what? We're gonna have company, okay? We're gonna have company, and we're coming to your house. So when we knock, open that door. We're gonna be there, gonna have conversations with you. So I'll tell you a couple channels that we are gonna add as well, okay? Be prepared, I'll just let you know. We are going to do a Boom Book Club. Boom, a Boom Book Club, and we're gonna do a daily reading book club. We'll get back with you on the start of that. I'm just putting that out there. I'll give you two other channels that we're gonna add as well, okay? A daily book club that we'll do. It will be a reading, a discussion, just a little 30-minute session that we'll do. We'll find a day, you know, within there, and some of it will be opposite some of the other channels that we have. Like Lori's been working like crazy. I get on Lori's call all the time. I get on all the calls, and it's just been phenomenal. And so, like, you'll see she staggers. And so to fill that slot, we're going to maybe put a book club on the days that she don't do it, or one of these other channels. And I got to tell you another channel that we're going to do. This is cool. We're going to do the first Boom cooking show. We are going to do a cooking show, and that cooking show is going to be just coming to you, showing you how to have meals at your home, creative things, inexpensive things. I'm going to teach you guys how to make, you know, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. I'll teach you how, like, I make an incredible omelet. I'll show you guys how I prepare omelets. Me and Ed, we've already talked about it. We're going to get together, put our chef hat on. We're going to do one session together as well. And but we're going to have a cooking show for you. And that way, every, we'll do that maybe two or three times a week or something like that. And just have some fun. It has nothing to do with selling Ibüümerangs or selling product or whatever it is, but we're family. And we want to provide whatever we need to provide for every one of you. And anybody's welcome if they want to get on there. Yeah, they'll hear us talk about Ibüümerang because that's just what we do sometimes. And it doesn't slip up. It's just automatic. But the purpose of it is just coming to you, your people. We care about you more than we care about your volume. We care about you, and we want to provide and be there with you and be tight with you. So I am really excited. There's other channels that I can't talk about now. Can I tell them one channel that we're going to do a promotion? Can I tell them about it? I've got the big mouth.
Yeah, go for it.
Now, you're going to have to qualify for this one. We are going to do a promotion. We'll announce it on probably this next Saturday's call. And we're going to do a promo. I'm not going to tell you how the promo is going to work, but we're going to do a promo. And we're going to celebrate. And we are going to throw a worldwide Saturday night party, and we are going to dress up and we're going to rock it, and you have to qualify to attend. I'm talking about DJs, I'm talking about hype, I'm talking about when we throw a party, we throw a party, okay? And we're going to do it. And it's going to be a big virtual party. It's going to be off the charts, but you can't come just because you're cute. Can't come just because, you know, what you did 2 years ago. You're going to have to qualify for it. Why? Because Fire Marshal says there's only so much room we can have for our party, or they'll shut the party down. Okay. You see, Mark is already ready. All right, DJ Marky Mark in the house. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. When I tell T. Gray and Mark, I'm coming on, and it's only going to be a short period of time. They're like, okay, because I was only supposed to come on to give you a couple of book club announcements. I was come on to give you the announcements for Boom TV. But love you guys so much. I'm addicted to sharing with you guys, and sometimes I have people say you overshare, you let them in too much, you give them a little too much, but I can't help it. I can't help it. We love you guys. We hope that you stay safe throughout all of these times here, and stay positive, and keep tuning in so we can cut those weeds out. Love you. I'll pass it back on to T. Gray and DJ Marky Mark.
Yeah, and he can't come alone. He's got to bring the funky bunch with him.
Yes, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch.
Gotta have the Funky Bunch, absolutely. Well, good, man. I tell you what, that was definitely a high-powered share with HB. We got a training out of that. We learned how to get the weeds out of the garden, the mental garden, and we got some new things coming up on Boom TV, which is super exciting. So cool stuff, cool stuff. Hey, Marky Mark, what else do we have for today?
Yeah, so I just want to say, you know, back at the beginning, Mr. Buggs had said something that kind of really hit home for me. You know, we are cognizant of people that are not doing so well. We are definitely cognizant of that. But one thing I want to do, and one thing that I can do myself to really put a smile on people's faces is doing what we're doing here.
Right.
And, you know, it doesn't mean we are not cognizant of what it is that you're experiencing or your family is experiencing. But I just want to say to be able to put a smile on your face, that's what we do this for. And the one thing that I also heard something, it was edutrainment. Yep. And that's one thing that we're doing here as well. So, you know, want to make it fun, want to make it light, and want to do our best for you.
Hey, Mark, and you know what? That's exactly what people want and what people need, right? I mean, it's the reason why when you have sick children in the hospital, they send a clown, right? Because, you know, everyone's already aware of what's wrong in the world right now and what's wrong in their life right now. And so it's our job to not only communicate the information, but to give everybody a pick me up. So I hope that this is a great pick me up. I hope this has been a bright spot in your week. And I hope it's a bright spot in your week every single week when you come here and you get your training, you get your updates, and we make you laugh a little bit while we're at it. So there you go.
Just bring it home.
We'll work to keep it not boring, and we won't let Mark wear a tie ever again.
Awesome. So I don't know if you guys realized it, but the digital training subscription that you have gotten, we've added 2 additional hours of trainings.
2 more hours? Hashtag stack it on the value.
That's right. That's right. Now, if you want to get it, you can get it in your back office. And so you'll log in, and then you'll go to tools, and then you'll go to training. Okay? Tools and training. All right. And again, that's $19.95 per month. But all we're doing is charging you the first month, $19.95, and then you get your next 6 months free.
Okay. That's right.
All right. And then we got the digital photo album. Oh, man. This is shaping up. It's really coming together. I know that we did another revision this week. And so Mrs. Buggs is engaged in this activity, and she is not going to put out anything that's less than absolutely flawless, like she did with the commemorative album from Vision, if you guys remember that. So that was beautiful. It was gorgeous. And we went through multiple revisions of that. So we're working on the digital photo album for you, looking at maybe next week releasing that for you. So those of you that had paid that $14.95, some Dr. Latrice bought 10 of them. So, but bottom line is this, that's coming. And when you do purchase this, it's another way to get proper servings of nutrition for the Boom Foundation for children. So that $4.95 goes directly to the Boom Foundation. All right, now convention special. These are the brochures and the giveaways that we had. Those are shipping. So some of you, if you've received your shipment, yeah, put it in the chat. I know that those are going out as we speak. Mr. Tunde has been sending those out, and his team have been sending those out. So shipping has not slowed down on those yet. Cynthia got mine yesterday. Michelle got mine. Adrena received package yesterday. So good stuff. So those are going out. People are receiving those. And we will put those up in the Boom Gear store, boomgear.com, but not yet. We want to get all of the shipments out. We want to make sure that everybody has that initial shipment before we start sending any more, before we start allowing people to order more of those. Okay, it takes two. Boy, these calls have been off the charts, T. Gray.
They have. They've been rocking them. And we just want to thank all of our diamonds and all of our, everybody who's been part of our It Takes Two presentation team. You guys have been bringing it. You've made yourself available. And every one of those calls has been absolute fire. Great job, you guys.
Excellent. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go through the names. Now, what does it mean to get two? And it takes two. So that's the Fast Start Accelerator bonus. You get paid seven levels deep if you get two, okay? Typically, it takes 10 to get paid seven levels deep. But if you get two in the month of March, so we're running out of time, guys. You're running out of time. So if you want to get your two and get paid seven levels deep in April, you need to go ahead and get people on the It Takes Two calls, or just get two. I mean, just call people up and say, hey, get in. We're doing this. Let's go. So bottom line is this, these folks, the folks coming up here right now, have gotten their two or more. So we'll be taking a look at that. All right, I'm going to take this first one, Tigre. LaKendra, Kamar, Juna, Eddie, Ricardo, Parker, Alicia, Rosita, Lucy, Gabriella, Angel, and Edward. You got your two.
Ready to go. Two. Gloria, Jay, Jose Alberto, Alma, Danica, Josefa, Mikal, Andreas, Arthur, Camila, Columba, Estrella, Javed, Aman, Saleh, Adair, Lily, Lee, and you did it to me again, Mr. Kithcart. You stacked up all the hard names on my page.
No, I did not.
It's a setup.
I was just going to say no names died in that reading, but okay, all right.
I almost died.
They got two. These folks said, hey, you know what? Two's not enough. I'm getting three.
Three, baby.
Iphigenia, Jesus, and Tanya. They got three.
Three. Yes. How about four? Juan, Aseda, and Tara all got four. Special effects, baby.
Got five. Francisco and Lori got five.
Yes, way to go. Abiel Gabriselesi got seven. Seven, baby. Abiel, and seven syllables, too.
Seven syllables and seven.
Seven syllables, at least seven.
All right. Gloria got 10.
10, baby, 10. Yes. Luis Mungare got 11. Can't do 11. Only got 10. Okay, yeah, that's 11. 11.
Yeah. Victor Dionisio got 15.
Can you believe it? 15? What quarantine? Way to go, Victor. And Josue Ortiz Lopez Soriano got 16, baby. 16.
Awesome.
I don't know how you do 16. You can't do.
All right. So that's it. I mean, so this is flight school.
Well, no, it's not it. That's not it. We got one more thing we got to show everybody.
What do we got?
One more thing. Hold on. One more thing, because our folks are so amazing. They have to know what they did. And folks, this is what you did. Boom, baby. You did it. We asked you to go in and follow Boom Foundation, and the Boom Foundation wants to thank you. They started this call at 833 followers, and now they're over 1,200 because of you and how amazing you guys are. That's what I'm talking about. Boom, baby, boom. Yes.
Awesome.
Yep. So I'll tell you what, let's do something real fun. I mean, we had an amazing call. We got a lot of of incredible extras, and you know, HB definitely took us to some really great places. We're excited about the new Boom Gear programming. As we end this call, though, you know, Holton talked about the fact that we will travel again. We absolutely will travel again. So what we want to do is we're going to just take you to a happy time, take you back to one of our favorite trips that we've ever had with our Ibüümerang family. We'll show that as a video to wrap up the call. What do you think, Mark? I got it teed up. Mark, you still there? Marky Mark?
Yes. Yeah.
You think that's a good idea?
Yeah.
All right. Well, love you, brother, man. Thank you for bringing so much joy and happiness to the world today. We appreciate you I personally appreciate you for definitely making me laugh. I love you, man.
Love you too, bro. Love you all.
All right. We love you guys. We're going to play this video and we'll see you on the next episode of Boom TV, which is our 12 p.m. It Takes Two call.
On top of the world right now. The people that are here are going to be the future diamonds of Ibüümerang within the next 6 months or less. The next member only trip, make it.
Boom!
Boom!
I like to go outside when the sky is blue. They see that new Benz, they want to ride with you. All your old friends want to spend time with you. Back then, they want to spend a dime with you. Whoa. It's crazy how the tables turn.
To the stage, the CEO of Ibüümerang, Mr. Holton Buggs.
I'm not looking at your check and judging who you are by your check, because my check was less than yours. I look at you and I look at your potential. I look at you and I know you can be right up in here or on this stage if you choose to. I'm not looking at your check and judging who you are.
You fuego, yeah, set you on fire. Got me like gasolina, you a lighter, yeah. You my mamacita, you my rider, oh. Tastes like margarita when I bite her, oh. Colombiana, so slow with me now. In my cabana, I'ma take you down. Mami fuego, oh, she look like J-Lo. She want my peso, spend it on Rodeo.
When you leave here today is the first experience that we have done as Ibüümerang.
First of all, guys, congratulations on an incredible event. How many of you having a fantastic time? We got the best product in the world. The best product.
Some people.
people see the lion that's inside of you. That's why we're here today, because I want to show you and tell you I see the lion, every one of you here. The cat stayed home. Never make a decision to come to an event. Always come to an event to make a decision.